Fort Newcombs. Well, the only 25-year-old became a ward of the state when he was 3. They put him in the Sierra Child Care Center. They discharged him when he was 18. Here's the address and the director's name.
Thank you very much, Rhea. I sure appreciate this.
Well, it was nothing. You bribed me with the sweet rolls.
Yeah. Well, you know, when I bought them, I kind of had in mind that maybe one of them might be for me. No.
Mm-mm. I don't have to watch my figure. You do.
Welcome back to our channel. Welcome back to the Bronco. What we're going to talk about in this video is the roll cage. The roll bar that comes with the kit, you get the box lid so you can see it, is nowhere near close to what we saw on TV. This is what comes with the kit. And that's like, that's just ain't going to work. Kind of like the wheels on Tara's car that were like, you know, really different. We just can't ignore that because it's so far off that we have to do something about it. So I don't have much styrene rod. And the styrene rod I do have is too big. This is 1/8, and that's just too big. And also I have 1/16, but that's too small. So I could have, you know, bought a whole bunch of different sizes of styrene rod, some of the evergreen or plastruck, but our hospital bills are starting to come in from my wife's ordeal. So right now a golf course has more green than I do, so that wasn't going to happen. I have a small bag of scrap sprue, and in that bag was a sprue from out of a 172nd aircraft kit. And it was perfect diameter. So this is what's this is what's left of the sprue, right there. That pile right there is what's left after I cut it all up to make the roll cage. Now this is just all mocked up because I needed to get it mocked up so I can get that angle of the front bars here to go with the angle of the windshield. But using pictures, like the same pictures I used to paint the body, I think I got it pretty damn close what we saw on TV. Here is a kind of like a rear shot of the setup that he had, and here's a side shot, and then here's a top down shot, but there's a side shot and then there's mine. So I think we've done a pretty good job of copying it. It's not perfect, but it's I got it pretty close. So this back bar that you see here, I pulled that on my junk box and I built the rest of this around that back bar, which is why I needed to match the diameter of the rest of the roll cage. What I had to do on this is I had to lengthen it because it wasn't wide enough. So I had to add probably about 1/4 inch to this bar to widen it, and then it wasn't tall enough, so I had to add about 1/4 inch, same amount to the bottom here, to raise it up, and then that gave me my back bar. Then the rest I just used these pictures, points on the body as a reference. This shot really helped me a lot, and then just made the front part out of sprue. And then once I had it all glued together, I used Gorilla super glue to put it together. And then once the Gorilla CA was dry, I went over all the joins with my Tamiya Thin, just to kind of strengthen everything up, you know. And then once that was all done, I went back with my skinny stick. Once I had it all glued together and it was dry, I used my skinny stick here and I rounded off all the sharp edges because, you know, all my cuts were angle cuts. And as you can see in the roll bar, pictures of the roll bar, you know, it's you know, the bars were bent. They weren't, you know, so you have everything's round, and you know, you didn't have joins where you had sharp edges like I had. So after, as I said, after the glue was dry, I went back with my skinny stick. Yeah. And I knocked off all those sharp edges. I kind of rounded them off, softened them up. And then once I had all that done, then I painted it black. And then I cleared it with Krylon matte acrylic. And that's the roll cage. I think it came out pretty good. I think it looks the part. All I got to do now, and I'll probably use masking tape, is put some padding on it, because the roll bar here, or cage, had padding on it on TV and here and there. So I'm going to do the same thing, I guess. And for that, I can just use masking tape, paint it black, cut me some masking tape off, and then there's padding on the side bars. There's a little pad right here on the rear supports. And then it looks like there is a pad on the back here. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 places where it had padding, and we can emulate the same just using masking tape. And then we can paint the masking tape black, and then I think we'll be okay. So I think that's going to do. As I said, not perfect, but I think it'll do. And I do have some new kits coming. My brother, again, was on the road, and he ran across a antique shop. I think down by Cincinnati, I think he said, because he was down in the Cincinnati, Dayton area. He wanted to stop in there, and he found some truck kits. So we'll look at those once he brings those up. And, yeah, it'll be fun. All right, guys. Take care. We'll see you.